Hello, this is Roger with Google. This recording is a getting started using Google Docs on Microsoft Windows using the NVDA Screen Reader and the Firefox browser. In this recording, I will describe the major sections of the application, how to move between those sections, how to do basic editing, how to do basic navigation within a document, and how to get additional information. Let's get started. I previously navigated to drive.google.com, and now I'm going to use the down arrow to get to the document that I want to open up.
My drive-google drive-mozilla firefox left parent private browsing right parent my drive-google drive document folder list view list stuff Google Drive folder owned by me last modified by me September 4th sample Google Docs owned by me last modified by me 8:52 a.m. Google Docs files do not take up quota space 3 of 7.
Before I open this up, I want to talk about a one-time setup that you need to do when you're using Google Docs, Sheets, and Slides on Microsoft Windows or the Mac platforms. To know if the one-time setup needs to be performed, listen to the verbalization that occurs when you open up a document. So let's listen as I open up this file.
Document. You are online. To enable screen reader support, press shortcut Control plus Alt plus Z to learn about keyboard shortcuts.
I went ahead and pressed Control key there. You may have heard during the verbalization the phrase, to enable screen reader support, press Control Alt Z. When you hear that, that's an indication that the one-time setup has not been performed. I'm going to do that now by pressing Ctrl-Alt-Z, as in zebra.
Screen reader support enabled. Grouping. Screen reader support enabled. On page 1.
I just pressed the Control key to silence the verbalization. As you heard, when I did press Ctrl-Alt-Z, it told me that screen reader support is now enabled. Again, this is a one-time setup, and you don't have to do it the next time you open the document. I'm going to go ahead and close this file and reopen it so you can hear the verbalization that occurs when screen reader support has been enabled. I'm going to press Ctrl-W now to return back to Drive.
My Drive-Google Drive document. Folder list.
I press Ctrl to silence the verbalization. My focus is already on sample file, so I'm going to simply press Enter again to open it up. Again, let's listen to the verbalization that occurs when open up this document.
Busy. You are online. Screen reader support enabled. Sample-Google Docs.
I press the Control key to silence the output. During that verbalization, the phrase screen reader support enabled was spoken, so that's an indication that the one-time setup has already been performed. The Google Docs application consists of several major areas. The primary one is the document area, and that's where you'll be creating and editing and reading content. There is also an application menu, a top toolbar, a main toolbar, and a context-sensitive menu that can be opened up. The document I opened up had little content, but let's go ahead and read it by using the arrow keys. I'm going to press the up arrow now.
This is a sample document.
That read the first line of the document. I'm going to do a down arrow again. So in this document, all we have is the first line of text. So I'm going to go ahead and arrow up again.
This is a sample document.
I'm going to hit end to go to the end of the line. Enter. Now I'm going to type in another line of text. Now I'm going to press up arrow to read the line that I just typed in.
This is a second line of text.
To read content within a document, you can use several different techniques. You can go character by character by using the left and right arrow keys. I'm going to press the right arrow key a few times.
T. H. I. S. I. S.
You can also move word at a time by using control with the left and right arrow keys. I'm going to do that a couple times.
A. Second. Line of text.
You can also read paragraphs at a time by using control up and down arrow. I'm going to do a control up arrow.
This is a second line of text.
I'm going to do control up arrow again.
This is a sample document.
As I mentioned earlier, there's an application menu. To access the application menu, you press Alt, Shift, and another letter like F as in file, I as in insert, or O as in format. I'm going to press Alt, Shift, F now.
File submenu 1 of 10.
You can use the left and right arrow key to explore the application menu.
Edit submenu 2 of 10. Viewed submenu 3 of 10. Insert submenu 4 of 10. Viewed submenu 3 of 10. Edit submenu 2 of 10. File submenu 1 of 10.
You can use the down arrow to open up and go through the menu items. I'm going to do a down arrow a couple times.
Share. Wests. Email. 1 of 1. New. Hence. Email. Submenu 1 of 6.
To activate a menu item, simply press Enter. Or if you want to abandon this and go back to your document, press Escape, and that's what I'm going to do now.
Document region. Menu bar. //.
I press Control to silence the verbalization. Another way you can do things in the application menu is to press Alt/ to do a search through the menus. I'm going to do so now.
Search the menus //. Edit has autocomplete. Blank.
Now I'm going to type in REN.
List. Rename. 1 of 1.
So it found the rename menu item. I'm going to go ahead and hit enter to rename this document.
Rename document dialog. Enter a new document name : edit has autocomplete. Selected sample.
The name of this document is currently sample, so I'm going to rename it to be example.
So.
Now I'm going to press enter to rename the document.
Example. Weissenweg:/.
I press Control to silence the verbalization. To confirm, you can press NVDA+T to read the title of the tab. I'm going to do so now.
For example, -google/docs/mozilla/firefox/left/private/browsing/right/.
So I just described how to get to the application menu. To get to the top toolbar, you first go to the application menu by pressing Alt-Shift-F.
File submenu 1 of 10.
Then you would do Shift-Tab.
Share. Private to only me. Button.
And you continue doing Shift-Tab to go through other toolbar items in the top toolbar. I'm going to do Shift-Tab one more time.
Open comments, thread left parent shortcut control +Alt+Shift+A right parent toggle button.
I don't want to activate any of the top toolbar items, so I'm going to press Escape to return back to the document.
Document region.
Or press Control to silence the output. To get to the main toolbar, first go to the application menu by pressing Alt-Shift-F.
File submenu 1 of 10.
Then press Tab twice.
Alt, main toolbar. Print left parent shortcut control +P right parent button.
To reach other items in the main toolbar, you can use the left and right arrow key. I'm going to go ahead and escape and return back to the document.
For example, -Google Docs. Document region. Weissenweg:/.
I press Control to silence the output. Now we're going to do some more editing and formatting of the document. I'm going to arrow down to get to the bottom of the document.
This is a second.
I'm going to hit enter a couple times. Now we're going to start a new section, and I call this Movie Genres.
M-O-V-I-E-G-N-R-E-S.
I'm going to press up arrow to read the text that I just typed in.
Movie Genres.
Let's change this text to a Heading 1 style. First, let's open up the format menu by pressing Alt-Shift-O as in orange.
Format submenu 5 of 10.
And now you'll down arrow to get to the menu item you want. And I'm just going to go through this rather quickly.
Bold, these, italic, vice, underline, use, and strike through, case, superscript, subscript, R, paragraph styles, P's, Emil, submenu 1 of 4.
So I want to change the paragraph style. Now I'm going to do a right arrow to open up the submenu.
Increase indent, shortcut control +right bracket. 1 of 2.
Now I'm going to do down arrow.
Decrease indent, shortcut control +left bracket.
I'm going to continue to do a down arrow.
Normal text submenu 1 of 9. Title submenu 2 of 9. Subtitle submenu. Heading 1 submenu 4 of 9.
So now I'm going to do a right arrow to go to the submenu for heading 1.
Apply heading 1 shortcut control +Alt+1. Now object 1 of 2. Menu submenu.
Now I'm going to press enter to activate this item.
Heading 1 style applied. Weissenweg:.
I press control to silence the output. Now I'm going to do an up arrow and then a down arrow.
Heading 1 movies genres.
Another way you can change the paragraph style to a different type of heading is to press Control-Alt followed by a number between, say, 1 and 6. In this case, I want to do Control-Alt-2 to change this to a Heading 2 style.
Heading 2 style applied.
Now I'm going to do a down arrow. So now we want to type in a few movie genres. I'm going to type in action.
Oh.
Adventure.
D-V-E-R.
Comedy.
C-M-E-Y.
Horror.
O-R-R-R.
And romance.
O-C.
Now I'm going to do an up arrow.
Misspelling romance.
Well, looks like I misspelled romance. The context menu does offer spelling suggestions. To open up the context menu, press Control-Shift-X as in X-ray.
Menu, submenu.
Down arrow.
Spelling suggestion : romance 2 of 2.
I'm going to press enter to activate.
Weissenweg:/\12\HDD.
I press control key to silence the output. I'm going to continue to do an up arrow.
Horror.
Up arrow.
Comedy. Adventure. Action. Heading to movies on res.
Now I'm going to do a down arrow.
Action.
So these would actually be better if they were set up as a bulleted list. So now I'm going to press shift and the down arrow at the same time.
Adventure selected. Comedy selected. Horror selected. Romance selected.
I'm going to change these to a bulleted list by pressing Control Shift 8.
Create a bulleted list with 5 items.
Now we'll go through this again by using the up and down arrow keys.
Bullet, adventure, bullet, comedy, bullet, horror, bullet, romance, unselected. Heading to movies on res. Bullet, action. Bullet, adventure. Bullet, comedy. Bullet, horror. Bullet, romance.
Now let's create another section called Going to a Movie.
G. O. I. G. O. I. E.
I'm going to do an up arrow to go back to that text.
Going to a movie.
Let's again change this to a heading to by pressing Control Alt 2.
Heading to style applied.
This time I want to create a set of steps for going to a movie. So let's type in the first line.
C O O O V I E.
I'm going to do an up arrow.
Choose a movie.
In this case, we want this to be a numbered list. So I'm going to press Control Shift 7 to start a numbered list.
Create a numbered list with 1 item.
I'm going to press N to go to the end of the line. Now I'm going to press Enter.
2 point.
Now you will notice that it's creating a numbered list. So I'll continue to type in the steps of going to a movie.
C, S, 3 point. T, O, V, H, A, T, E, R, 4 point. K, D, E, F, T, V, A, R, I, F, E, V, E, 5 point. E, Y. F-A-F-I, F-6 point, F-F-T, 7 point, E-F-O-E-O-I, E-8 point.
It did create another number item. When I press Enter again, then it's going to remove that unwanted numbered item.
Removed list item, 8.
Now I'm going to do an up arrow to review the steps.
7 point, enjoy the movie. 6 point, find a seat. 5 point, buy snacks and drinks. 4 point, pick up a discrete speed of variation device.
That one didn't sound quite right, so I suspect I did a typo when I typed in the text. We'll show you in a little bit how to review for typos.
3 point, travel to the movie theater. 2 point, buy tickets. 1 point, choose a movie. Heading to going to a movie.
To check if there are spelling errors, you can use the control apostrophe or single quote to move to the next misspelling. I'm going to do so now.
Misspelling normal text discrete speed of.
Yep, I did misspell descriptive. So I'm going to press Control Shift X to get spelling suggestions.
Menu submenu.
Down arrow.
Spelling suggestion colon. Descriptive 2 of 2.
I'm going to press Enter to accept.
Weissenweg colon slash slash.
I press Control to silence the output. I'm going to press Control apostrophe to go to the next misspelling.
Misspelling variation.
I'm going to again press Control-Shift-X to get a list of spelling suggestions.
Menu, submenu.
Down arrow.
Spelling suggestion colon. Narration 2 of 2.
Enter to accept.
Weissenweg colon flat.
I press Control again to silence the output. I'm going to press Control apostrophe to go to the next misspelling. Yay, there is no more misspellings. There are several ways to navigate around the document. I'm going to press Control-Home to go to the top of the document.
This is a sample document.
There is a next and a previous shortcut available. The next shortcut is a two-step shortcut. You first press Control-Alt-N, followed by Control-Alt, another letter, depending on the type of movement you want to do. For example, H for heading, L for list, C for comment. I'm going to press Control-Alt-N, Control-Alt-H to move to the next heading.
Heading to movies on res.
I'm going to do it again.
Heading to going to a movie.
To go to the previous, press Control-Alt-P, followed by Control-Alt and another letter, like H for heading. I'm going to press Control-Alt-P, Control-Alt-H.
Heading to movies on res.
You can also move to the next list by pressing Control-Alt-N, followed by Control-Alt-O as in orange.
Bullet action.
I'm going to do it again.
1 point, choose a movie.
I'm going to press Control-Home to go to the top of the document.
This is a sample document.
Before I show you the next type of movement, I'm going to do a little bit of formatting here. I might do a control right arrow to get to the word sample.
Is a sample.
I'm going to select it by pressing control shift right arrow.
Sample selected.
Now I'm going to change it to bold.
Bold. Checked. Applied to selection.
I'm going to do a control up arrow to read this paragraph and move focus to the beginning of the paragraph.
Sample unselected.
Another way you can check formatting information is to do the announce formatting shortcut, which is Control-Alt-A as in announce, followed by Control-Alt-F as in format. I'm going to press that now.
Normal text.
You can move to the next format change by pressing Control-Alt-N, followed by Control-Alt-W as in Word. I'm going to do this so now.
Started bold.
And here you may notice that it said starting bold. If you do Control-Alt-N, Control-Alt-W again.
Ended bold.
And you'll notice there that said it ended the bold. So I'm going to move my focus back into the word sample.
Sample, yes. A.
I'm going to announce the formatting again by pressing Control-Alt-A, followed by Control-Alt-F.
Normal text, bold.
I'm going to show you another keyboard shortcut. First, I'm going to move to the top of the document by pressing Control-Home.
This is a sample document.
I'm going to move to the first heading by pressing Control-Alt-N, followed by Control-Alt-H.
Heading to Movies Genres.
You can read from your current cursor location to the end of the document or until you press Control by pressing Control-Alt-R, as in Read. I'm going to do so now.
Heading to Movies Genres Bullet, Action Bullet, Adventure Bullet, Comedy Bullet, Horror Bullet, Romance Heading to Going to a Movie 1. Choose a Movie 2. Buy Tickets 3.
I went ahead and pressed Control to silence the output. One thing to note is that when you are doing a read-all and you stop the verbalization, the focus remains at the point it was when you first started reading and has not moved to the point where you stopped the reading. So now if I do an up arrow and a down arrow, it'll still be on movie genres.
Heading to movie genres.
Google Docs has lots of keyboard shortcuts available. To get a list of the shortcuts, press Control/.
Keyboard shortcuts dialog.
When you do open up this dialog and you're using NVDA, you will need to go into browse mode by pressing NVDA spacebar.
Keyboard shortcuts, dialog heading.
I press Control to silence the verbalization. Now I'm going to press T to move to the table of keyboard shortcuts.
Table with 55 rows and 2 columns. Popular keyboard shortcuts dialog.
Now I'm going to press the down arrow so you can hear the first few keyboard shortcuts.
Row 1, column 1, heading, level 3, text formatting. Column 2. Row 2, text formatting, column 1, bold. Column 2, control plus B. Row 3, text formatting, column 1, italic. Column 2, control plus I. Row 4, text formatting, column 1, underline. Column 2, control plus U.
I'm going to press escape to return back to my document.
Wife awake, colon, slash, left.
I press control to silence the verbalization. We also have online documentation. You can find this documentation a couple different ways. You can do a Google search for Get Started Using Google Docs with a Screen Reader, or you can go to google.com/accessible where you will find product information on this and other products, as well as links to online documentation. Thank you for listening, and I hope you found this recording useful.
This work is licensed under a Creative Commons Attribution 4.0 international license, which can be found at http://creativecommons.org/licenses/by/4.0/. You are free to share, copy, and redistribute this material in any medium or format.